Complete setup for the dissectable machine experiments, and there are the parts of it are like, first part is, this is the circuit breaker part. The red button is the emergency circuit power off, and this part is the circuit breakers. And then we have a variable DC and AC supplies. With this knob you can control the supply voltage. These are the three phase AC supply, RYB neutral, and this is the two terminals of the DC supply. And this is fixed voltage AC and DC supply. This AC is 400 volt line to line voltage and 230 volt line to neutral voltage, and DC supply is 220 volt 5 ampere max fixed DC supply. And then we have rheostat, a variable resistance, and these are all the various measuring instruments, voltmeter, ammeters, and measuring instruments. And here we have actually the setup. At the two ends you can see holdings for the bearings and supports for the shaft. Actually, in between there will be bearings and a shaft will be oriented. And this part is your yoke, from where the salient poles will be mounted for DC machines, and AC machine stator will also be mounted inside it. These are the various parts which will be used for making a DC machine. The various parts are, at the very beginning, let us concentrate on DC field pole shoes, which will be sitting on the stator, and around which there will be field windings, which are here. These two are the field coils, which will be around these pole shoes. This is, you can see one coil, and these two are the two terminals for these field coils, and these are the two nuts used for fitting these pole shoes in the stator yoke. And this is the shaft, and you can see two bearings which will be at the end of the shafts for frictionless motion. And in the middle you have this arrangement which is used for fitting the armature pole shoes on top of it. And these four are the armature pole shoes which will be sitting on top of the shaft here, with the help of these four nuts. And around them there will be armature windings. These two are the inner armature windings, and these two are outside. This, you can see, is the commutator, and here you have this brake drum and loading arrangement. So these are, as a whole, the parts used for making a DC machine. Here you can see, this is the pole shoe, and with which the field winding coil has already been fit, and after that it is being fit on top of the stator with a screw. So this is one pole shoe with one field winding coil, and another one exactly in the similar way are done. So this is basically, we are looking at a two pole DC machine. Yes, and for getting a tight fit we can use this. So now we'll see how to do the armature winding. This thing is the shaft, and as you can see in the shaft there is one part is comparatively longer and one part is comparatively shorter. Now this longer part is for the commutator. So commutator has to come here in this part, so which means your armature windings invariably has to have its coil terminals, means these coil terminals, in that side. So according to that you have to do the armature windings. Another thing important is that you can see here on this setup where you have to mount the armature pole shoes, there are markings, like this is B, C, B, A. Okay, So these, according to these markings, you have to mount these armature pole shoes. Even in armature pole shoe, you can see there are markings. Like you can see here, there it is B, it's A. So this A pole shoe has to go here in A. According to that, you have to do this mountings. Here, this A armature pole shoe is being fit on the A side of the shaft with a screw here. And it is not fully tight, just mounted. And then we have to take the inner armature winding and place it like this. Okay, now the important thing is this coil terminals are towards the longer side of the shaft, because these have to go to the commutator setup. Here the commutator setup will be there, and here is another inner armature coil, and also you can see the coil terminals in the same side. And this is the outer armature coil which comes on top of this. And now the B pole shoe is taken and it is being fit on its corresponding place on top of the shaft, and it will be tightly mounted with a knot. Okay, so now the armature winding is mostly held. Now one thing you can concentrate here is that this coil's curvature side has to be towards the shaft. You have to keep it in mind from the very beginning. And like this, you have now two slots for the two more armature pole shoes, which has to be placed in their corresponding places and mounted. So this is how it looks after the fitting of all armature coils and armature pole shoes. Now here the commutator segment is being fit on the rotor, on the shaft. Okay, so here it is how we do our coils connections with the commutator setup. In the commutator setup, you can see the red terminal of one coil is being connected with the black terminal of the next coil at the same commutator segment. And so on for the next coils, that red terminal of that particular coil with the black terminal of that next coil is connected at the same point of the next commutator segment. Black or yellow, here it is the yellow terminal, but it is marked as black. So on for the next commutator segments. This is the complete armature winding along with the commutator setup. This is how it looks after the complete setup. And here you can see these connections, one coil red with the next coils yellow or black. Yes, the commutator has to be fixed with the shaft with a screw. Now we are going to mount the armature winding in the yoke. Now for that we have to remove one side of the end holdings, which you can remove with the nuts and bolts at the base. And the next part is fitting the bearings at the end holdings. Now here one bearing is being fed. Okay, and this part is to hold the bearing in its place so that it does not come out of its slot. Two screws are used to put the holding at its place. So next we are going to fit the carbon brushes. You can see these two are the carbon brushes, and this part is basically the carbon brush, and inside it there is a spring structure which holds the carbon brush tight on to the commutator segment. And here just below the shaft and the commutator, you have this thing which is the holder for the carbon brush, where here you have a slot for the screw where the carbon brush segments are tightly fit. The carbon brush is being fit with the screw here. And here the carbon brush touches the commutator segment. Okay, so this is how it looks after the final complete setup with carbon brushes. Now these are two carbon brushes fitted with the carbon brush holder, and then these two terminals coming from two carbon brushes, one is here and another is here. These two terminals become the two terminals of the armature winding, and through these two terminals DC supply to the armature winding is given. For right now, these two are holded by these dummy holders at the basement, one here and one here. Okay, this is the brake drum. Now we are doing the loading arrangement. At the first we'll mount the brake drum on the end part of the shaft. Okay, so here the loading arrangement is being done. This part is the brake drum that you have seen, and on top of which there is a belt, and this belt is mounted on top of this brake drum, and by this knob we can make this belt tight or loose, and according to which our mechanical load on the shaft on this DC machine will vary. Now this whole setup is being fitted with the basement with nut and bolt structure. There are two nuts and bolts. Okay, so this is how it looks after the final setup of this loading arrangement. And at the side there is a structure with a scale that you can see here. Now this knob is used to make the pointer at 0 Nm at no load condition, 0 Nm at no load condition. And then as you want to increase the load, you have to use this knob with which you can tighten this belt, and accordingly this indicator here will move and you can see the amount of loading in Newton meter. Now at the end what we have to do is we have to do the proper field connections. Now these two are sitting in the stator as field windings, as we have mentioned earlier. Now we need a unidirectional field in this direction, unidirectional field perpendicular to the shaft. So for that we need to connect these two coils in series. So you can see from this terminal we are connecting this terminal, and the remaining two terminals are the field winding terminals. Here is one and here is another. So this series connection gives us a unidirectional field perpendicular to the shaft. And at the end there is a cover. So this is the whole disconnectable DC machine.